Hello everybody, how are you? Wherever you're coming in from, whether it's Facebook or Instagram or your own whatever personal channel. My name is Phelim Drew, and you're very welcome to the Temple Bar Sessions. So it's wonderful to be, to be in town, in a pub, but unfortunately there's no drink, and there's a very small audience, but hopefully you're coming in from somewhere abroad, or you could even be tuning in from Bray, and you'd be very welcome wherever you're from. So, as I said, my name is Phelim, and I'm going to be with you for the next three quarters of an hour or so. So I'm going to start off with this song, and this is a song that it was sung actually by my father. So he sang it on a show called Ballad Sessions on RTE back in the 60s, and I've just started revisiting all these songs over the last few years, and I think they're wonderful. And so I hope you enjoy this. This is called The Kerry Recruit. One morning in March, I was digging the land. With me broke on me feet, me spade, me hand. Says I to myself, such a pity to see such a fine strapping lad putting turf round to lay with me to them. With me turum and ah, turum and urum and urum and ah. So I buttered me brogues, shook hands with me spade, and off to the fair like a dashing young blade. And up comes a sergeant, he asked me to list, and a sergeant a grosh, stick him off in me fist. With me turum and ah, with me turum and ah. Victorum and Orum and Orum and Ah. Well, the first thing they gave me, it was a red coat and a white strap of leather to wrap round me throat. They gave me a queer thing, I asked, what is that? They told me it was a cockade for me hat. With me turum and ah, with me turum and ah. With me turum and urum and urum and ah. Well, the next thing they gave me, they called it a gun, with powder and shot and a place for me thumb. Well, first she spat fire and then she spat smoke. Lord, she gave a great leap and me shoulder near broke. With me turum and ah, with me turum and ah. With me turum and urum and urum. Well, the next place they sent me was down by the quay, on board of a warship bound for the Crimea. Three sticks in the middle, all round with sheets. Fate, she walked on the water without any feet. With me turum and ah, with me turum and ah. With me turum and urum and urum. When at Balaclava we landed quite sound, cold, wet and hungry we lay on the ground. The next morning for breakfast the bugle did call, and we had a hot breakfast of powder and ball. With me turum and ah, with me turum and ah. Turum and urum and urum and ah. We fought at the Alma likewise in command, and the Russians they leathered us at the Red Ann. In scaling the wall there meself lost an eye, and a big Russian bullet ran away with me thigh. With me turum and ah, with me turum and ah. With me turum and urum and urum and ah. Was there we lay bleeding all on the cold ground, heads, legs and arms were all scattered round. I thought of me mam and me they bury me decent and raise a loud cry with me Turamana, with me Turamana, with me Turamana, Turamana, Turamana. They call for a doctor, he soon staunched me blood, and he gave me a fine elegant leg made of wood. They gave me a medal and 10 pence a day. Contented with Sheila, I live on half pay. With me Turamana, with me Turamana, with me Turamana, Turamana, Turamana.
So that's all there is to that. But I love those songs that come from the 18th century and the 19th century. They're little pocket history lessons in a way. And this next song is a little bit more recent, I suppose. It was written about a doctor called Dr. Johnson, whose car was commandeered by the rebels in the north during an early exercise in early 20th century revolutionary activities in the country. And apparently the thing he was most upset about was the reference in the song to the fact that the car made a lot of noise when it went over the hills. So he wasn't really that concerned about the car being stolen or anything, or its use. This is called Johnson's Motor Car. It was down by Egan's Corner one morning I did stray. I met a fellow rebel, and this to him did say, I have orders from the captain to assemble at Drumbar. Ah, but how are we to get there without a motor car? Oh, Barney dear, be of good cheer, I'll tell you what we'll do. For the specials, they are plentiful, and the IRA are few. We'll wire up to Stranorlar before we go that far, and we'll give the boys a bloody good ride in Johnson's motor car. When Dr. Johnson got the news, he soon put on his shoes. He said, this must be an urgent case, I have no time to lose. He put on his fancy castor hat and on his breast a star. You can hear the din going through Glenfin of Johnson's motor car. Well, when he came to the railway bridge, the rebels he saw there. Johnson knew the game was up, and at him they did stare. I have a royal permit for to travel near and far. You can show your bloody permit, we want your motor car. What will my loyal brethren say when they hear the news? My car, it has been commandeered by the rebels at Dunluce. So we'll give you a receipt for it all, signed by Captain Marr. And when Ireland gets our freedom, you'll get your motor car. Well, we set the car in motion and filled her to the brim. With rifles and with bayonets, which made L. Johnson grim. Barney hoisted his Sinn Féin flag and it fluttered like a star. And we gave 3 cheers for the IRA in Johnson's motor car. Now when the specials got the news, they soon put on their shoes. They've stolen Johnson's motor car, there is no time to lose. They search the valleys high and low, they search both near and far. Abbey and the boys were far away in Johnson's motor car. We set the car in motion and filled her to the brim. With rifles and with bayonets, which made L. Johnson grim. Chuck Barney hoisted a Sinn Féin flag and it fluttered like a star. And we gave three cheers for Ayrton Doyle in Johnson's motor car. So there you are, there's Johnson's motor car. So, I hope everybody's not going too crazy in whatever part of the world they're in with all this, all these restrictions and lockdowns. I know it's affecting people's work in some cases more than others, but I think we're all kind of could do with a bit more of a social life. So it would be great to get out to the cinema and the theatre and to the bars for more live music. As I said, I've been dipping into the archives, as it were, for a lot of these songs. And I haven't heard Johnson's Motor Car being sung recently, and kind of taken the opportunity to sing a few of these songs. And Marty and the guys at the Temple Bar have been very hospitable, having myself and a few others, a few of the guys who play with me now and again, along. And it's great to be able to kind of just informally play through the songs and play some stuff that I wouldn't normally play. A song that that seems to go down quite well. I did this on the Late Late Show one night, and it went well. But it's a song that the Dubliners used to do. These are all, I suppose, Dubliner songs or related to the Dubliners in some way. My father, whose name was Ronnie, was a member of the Dubliners, a founding member. And he's 12 years dead this year. And so it feels very cathartic to get up in front of audiences and to engage with this music, and it's good for me because I can be quite shy about singing in public. I'm an actor and have been for years. So I'm having great fun with these 4 minute little stories, and this is no different. So this is Three Lovely Lassies from Kimmage, and as one of the guys said earlier on, if you're sitting at home with a glass of wine, or if you've got your own keg in the sitting room and you're having a pint, please feel free to sing along if you feel so inclined. And I'll imagine you there. There were three lovely lassies from Kimmage. There were three lovely lassies from Kimmage. And mine was the belle of the ball. And mine was the belle of the ball. There were three lovely lassies from Kimmage. There were three lovely lassies from Kimmage. And mine was the toughest of all. Sure, mine was the toughest of all. Well, the cause of the row was Joe Cashin. For he told me he thought I looked smashing at a dance in St. Anthony's Hall. At a dance in St. Anthony's Hall. Well, the other two young ones were flippin', they were flippin', they were flippin'. When they saw me and Joe and we trippin' to the strains of the Tennessee Waltz, to the strains of the Tennessee Waltz. Well, when he gets a few chairs, he goes frantic, goes frantic, goes frantic. But he's tired and he's tall and romantic, and I love him in spite of it all. And I love him in spite of it all. Well, he told me he thought we shouldn't marry. Shouldn't marry, shouldn't marry. He said it was foolish to tarry. So I lent him the price of the ring. So I lent him the price of the ring. Well, me da said he'd give us a present. A present, a present. A stool and a lousy stuffed pheasant. And a picture to hang on the wall. And a picture to hang on the wall. But I went down to the tenancy section in the corporation. The section, oh the section. The TD just before the election. Said he'd get us a house near me ma. Said he'd get us a house near me ma. Well, we're getting a house. The man said it. Oh yes, he said it. He said it. When I five or six kids to me credit. In the meantime, I live with me ma. In the meantime, I live with me ma.
So there you are. Three lovely lassies from Kimmage. And that's actually true, that bit of information in the song about needing a certain number of children before you qualified for one of these new council houses that the government were building in the 1930s and the 1940s. So it's extraordinary. And a lot of people were moved out from the tenements, out from houses that were really unfit for families. And there was all sorts of crazy criteria for people to get housing. And I remember hearing a story of one woman who said that she didn't qualify for a house because the inspector told her that she had enough space. And she says, how can you say I have enough space? She says, I'm living in a one-room tenement flat. And these were all Georgian houses that had once been very grand, and the ceilings were high. And he says, because the ceiling is so high. So they counted the space above, which was absolutely no use to the inhabitants. So that was the sort of bureaucracy that people were having to deal with back then. So this next song is a song that always reminds me of, makes me feel that it's kind of like an Irish blues song. And this song was given to my father by a wonderful street performer, a man who travelled around, a journeyman who travelled around to markets and fairs, a bit like the Dubliners in the early days. But this man was the real deal. He was the Pecker Dunn. And he wrote this song, and it's called Sullivan's John. So I'm singing this for you now.
Where would you get an L pot to mend? And where would you get
day that I went away to join the Tinker's band. Sullivan's John, to the road you've gone, far away from your native home. You've gone with a tinker's daughter, far along the road to Rome. Sullivan's John, you won't stick it long till your belly will soon get slack, and you'll roam the road with a heavy load and a toolbox on your back.
So there we are, Sullivan's John. Was it the Murphy sisters were on just before, and is that right, guys? And I just came in towards the end because of the COVID restrictions. They're trying to sort of stagger everyone, but it turns out they're from Clare Morris, and a very good friend of mine lives down there, so it's a small world. This next song is more of an American folk song. By the wonderful Mississippi John Hurt. So I don't claim to be justice in terms of musicianship, but I love this song, so if you'll indulge me, I'll have a go at this. And this is called The Ballad of Stack Lee.
Mr. Police Officer, how can it be you can arrest everybody except cruel Stack Lee? That bad man, cruel Stack Lee. Billy the Lion told Stack Lee, please don't take my life. I got two little children and a darling loving wife. That bad man, cruel Stack Lee. Well, what I care about your children and your darling loving wife. You done stole my Stetson hat, now I'm bound to take your life. That bad man, cruel Stack Lee. Boom, 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 with a 44. When I spied Billy the Lion, he was lying on the floor. That bad man, cruel Stack Lee. Well, gentlemen of the jury, what do you think of that? Stack Lee killed Billy the Lion for a $5 Stetson hat. That bad man, cruel Stack Lee. All they gathered, hands way up high. At 12 o'clock they killed him, and they were glad to see him die. That bad man, cruel Stack Lee.
Okay, so this is the barley and the grape rag. This is a song by Rory Gallagher, so I consider this song to be an Irish song as well. Anyway, I'll give it a whirl.
Well, I don't care if I get arrested, 'cause tonight they'll need more than a ball and chain. I don't care who's interested, well, I'm coming into town just the same. I've been feeling alone, I've been feeling blue, I think I need a little drink or two. Well, be my friend, tell me where that place is, where the whiskey flows and the dice roll till dawn. My baby done me wrong, you must have guessed it. Well, I feel so low, my life must be torn. I don't wanna know where east or west is, and I'm pretty sure tonight I won't feel the cold. Walking down Main Street, feeling no pain. Along comes a cop, he can take my name and explain to me what a federal case is. Yeah, I'm mixing the barley with the grape again. Bright city lights make me feel alright. I'm right or wrong, and tomorrow never comes. Yeah, I don't care if I get investigated, city fathers, they all black my name. Well, I'm pretty sure that you can smell the traces. Well, tonight I'll sleep out on a walking cane. I've been walking down Main Street feeling no pain. Along comes a cop, he can take my name and explain to me what a federal case is. Yeah, I'm mixing the barley with the grape again. City lights make me feel alright. I'm right or wrong, tomorrow never comes. Yeah, I don't care if I get arrested, 'cause tonight they'll need more than a ball and chain. I don't care who's interested, well, I'm coming into town just the same. I've been feeling alone, I've been feeling blue. Well, I guess I need a little drink or two. Well, be my friend, tell me where that place is, where the whiskey flows and the dice roll till dawn. Where the whiskey flows and the dice roll till dawn. Let's roll till dawn. Well, the whiskey flows and the dice roll till dawn.
Thank you very much. I like my blues songs, and I think the way music has gone from Ireland to America and back again is part of our story. This is a lovely song that was made famous by Paul Brady, called the Lakes of Pontchartrain. So I'm going to give this a whirl now. So it has that that Irish folk American folk flavor.
Stepped on board a railroad car beneath dark girl toward me came, and I fell in love with a Creole girl by the lakes of Pontchartrain. I said, my pretty Creole girl, my money is no good, and if it weren't for the alligators, I'd sleep out in the wood. You're welcome here, kind stranger, our house is very plain, but we never turned a stranger out by the lakes of Pontchartrain. She took me to her mother's house, and she treated me right well. The hair upon her shoulder in jet black ringlets fell. To try to paint her beauty, 'tis all in vain. So handsome was that Creole girl by the lakes of Pontchartrain. I asked her if she'd marry me. She said that this could never be, for she had got a lover and he was far at sea. She said that she would wait for him, that true she would remain, till he returned to his Creole girl by the lake so. So fare thee well, my Creole girl, I ne'er may see you more. I'll ne'er forget your kindness in your cabin by the shore, and at each social gathering a flowing glass I'll raise, drink a health to my Creole girl by the lakes of Pontchartrain.
Thank you very much. I suppose we have Mr. Paul Brady to thank for that song, not originally maybe, but for making it so well loved, especially here in Ireland. Paul played with Planksty, I think, at one stage, sang with them, as well as Christy Moore, wonderful Planksty. Liam O'Flynn and Andy Irvine and Don Maloney. So this is a song of theirs that I particularly like playing, and I hope you enjoy it. So it's called The Good Ship Kangaroo.
Well, once I was a waiting man, lived alone with thee. Now I am a mariner that plows the angry sea. I always loved seafaring life, I bid my love adieu, and I shipped a steward and company boys on board the Kangaroo. But I never thought she would prove false, or either prove untrue, as we sail away through Milford Bay on board the Kangaroo. Oh, think of me, oh, think of me, she mourned sorrowfully did say, when you are in a foreign land and I am far away, take this lucky threepenny bit, it'll make me bear in mind this loving, trusting, faithful heart you left in tears behind. Cheer up, my own true love, if you will but try. She sobbed, she sighed, she choked, she cried, but she could not say goodbye. For I won't be gone for very long, but for a month or two. And when I will return again, of course I'll visit you. But I never thought she would prove false, or either prove untrue, as we sail away through Milford Bay on board the Kangaroo. My ship it was homeward bound from many the foreign shore, and many the foreign present unto my love I bore. I brought tortoises from Tenerife, toys from Timbuktu, a China rat, a Bengal cat, and a Bombay cockatoo. Paid off I sought her dwelling on a street above the town, where an ancient dame upon the line was hanging out her gown. Where is my love? She's vanished, sir. She's gone 6 months or more, with a smart young man who drives a van for Chaplin, Son and Co. Ah, but I never thought she would prove false, or either prove untrue, as we sail away through Milford Bay on board the Kangaroo. So here's a health to married life, soap suds and blue, hearts to love and patent starch and wash and soda too. I'll go on to some foreign shore, no longer can I stay, and with some China hunting tot I'll throw my life away. My love, she is no foolish girl, my love, she is to score, my love, she is no spinster, she's been married twice before. I cannot say it was her will that stole my heart away. She's boiling clothes in the laundry for one night a day. Ah, but I never thought she would prove false, or either prove untrue, as we sail away through Milford Bay on board the Kangaroo. Ah, but I never thought she would prove false, or either prove untrue, as we sail away through Milford Bay on board.
So there you go, the good ship Kangaroo, it's got a great lilt to it. this next song that I'm going to sing is back in the vein of those wonderful songs from the early 19th century and the 18th century. This is a song called Mrs. McGrath, and I'll let the song do the work of telling the story. So, am I sort of going to the end of my set? Because I don't want to overstay my welcome, you know? I'll finish up quite soon. But I hope you've enjoyed the set. And it's been my pleasure playing for you and singing for you. So this is Mrs. McGrath.
Mrs. McGrath, the sergeant said, would you like to make a soldier out of your son, Ted? Scarlet coat and a big cocked hat, Mrs. McGrath, wouldn't you like that? But do-ra-ya, father, do-ta, do-ra-yo-ra-yo-ra-ya, but do-ra-ya, father, do-ta, do-ra-yo-ra-yo-ra-ya. Now Mrs. McGrath lived by the seashore, the space of 7 long years or more. Saw a big ship sailing into the bay. Here's my son Ted, will you clear the way? With me to Raya, Father Dilda, to Raya, Raya, Raya. With me to Raya, Father Dilda, to Raya, Raya, Raya. Captain dear, where have you been? Have you been to the Mediterranean? Do you hear any news of my son Ted? Is the poor fellow living now or is he dead? With me to Raya, Father Dilda, to Raya, Raya, Raya. With me to Raya, Father Dilda, to Raya, Raya, Raya. Karunkar, where are you blind? You left your two fine legs behind. I wasn't while walking on the sea, a big fish at your legs from the knees away with me, Uraya. Fada did that. Uraya, with me, Uraya. Fada did that. Uraya. Well, now when I wasn't drunk and I wasn't blind, and I left me two fine legs behind. A big cannonball on the 5th of May brought me two fine legs from the knees away with me, Uraya. Ah, tell me by the poor widow bride, so those two fine legs were your mammy's pride. Them old stumps of a tree wouldn't do at all. Push a wine in your arm from the big cannonball with the Uraya. Father did that. Uraya, with the Uraya. Father did that. Uraya. Now all foreign wars I do proclaim between Don Juan and the King of Spain. Behends I make them rue the time that they shot the legs from a child of mine. But me Uraya, Father did that. Uraya, with me Uraya. Father did that. Uraya.
So there you go, Mrs. McGrath looking after her son. So many mammies do. So I'm going to leave you quite shortly. I'll finish off with this great song, The Hot Asphalt, which tells the story of Irish immigrants in England working on the railways. And it's a powerful song. So it was made famous by Lou Kelly and the Dubliners, and I'll leave you with this, and unless the chaps would like me to stay and do another one, but we'll see how we get on. I don't know, I don't want to overstay my welcome. This is called The Hot Asphalt.
Good evening all me jolly lads, I'm glad to see you well, and if you gather all around me now, a story I will tell. Regard a situation, and begar and begun, I can whisper out the weekly wage of 19 pounds. 12 months come October since I left me native land, after helping in Killarney boys to bring the harvest down. But now I wear a ganzi and around me waist a belt, like the gaffer of the squad that makes the hot. If it doesn't last forever, sure I swear I'll ain't me hot. Well, I wander up and down the world, but sure I never felt any surface that was equal to the hot asphalt. Well, the other night a copper comes and say to me, Maguire, would you kindly let me light me pipe down at your boiler fire? He plants himself right down the front with hot nails up to late. Says I me days and tell me better go and build your break. He ups and yells, I'm down on you, I'm up to all your pranks. Don't I know you for a traitor from the Tipperary ranks? Boys, I hit straight from the shoulder and I gave him such a belt that I knocked him into the boiler full of the hot asphalt. We laid it in the hollers and we laid it in the flat. If it doesn't last forever, sure I swear I laid me hot. Well, I wandered up and down the road, sure I never felt any surface that was equal to the hot asphalt. Well, we quickly drug him up again and we threw him in the tub. With soap and water we began to rub and scrub. But divil the thing it hardened and they turned as hard as stone. And with every other rub you could hear the proper moan. And Pinkin says, O'Reilly, that he's looking like old Nick. Me if I'm not inclined to claim him with me stick. Now says I, it would be easier to boil him till he melts and store him nice and easy into the hot asphalt. We laid it in the hollers and we laid it in the flat. If it doesn't last forever, sure I swear I'll ache me hot. Well, I wandered up and down the world, but sure I never felt sailors, Jamaica, not a lot. Your shoemakers and your tailors, but we please the ladies best. The only ones who know the ways are Kitty Hearts to melt, are the lads around the boiler mixing a hot glass bowl. With rubbing and with scrubbing, sure I caught me death of cold, and for scientific purposes me body it was sold. The Kelvin Grove Museum boys, I'm hanging in me pelt, as a monument to the Irish mixing a hot glass bowl. We laid it in the hollers, we laid it in the flat. If it doesn't last forever, sure I swear I laid me hand. Well, I wandered up and down the world, but sure I never felt any surface that was equal to the hot asphalt.
So there we are now. That's how you know that this is live. Thanks very much. I've had a really nice time here at the Temple Bar, the Temple Bar Sessions. And so thank you, Temple Bar, the Temple Bar, for having me. Phelim Drew is my name. And I hope you enjoy everybody else that you see on the sessions. Thanks very much. Take care of yourselves.